All right, guys, we are back on the Minecraft server with ChurchMag for another Minecraft Theology. How you guys doing? It's been a while. We're back. So I am currently hanging out in my tree farm down in my basement underneath my house. And if you guys haven't seen this before, I actually did a couple of Let's Plays down here, either on my personal channel or on my or on ChurchMag. I can't remember, but you can go check those out. But today, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about fear. Before we get to fear, we're going to be doing something. We have a special delivery, as you might have guessed from the title of this episode. So the special delivery is that Red Tops, Benjamin, Red Tops is his Minecraft name, is looking for some stuff. And let me pull it up real quick. Make sure I have the right order. There we go. Alright, so he wants, he is building a place that we are calling Bible Land. By we, I mean he's calling it that because he's probably going to do majority, if not all, of the work. And he wants a whole bunch of stuff delivered to him. So, he wants three stacks of smelted stone. I assume that just means smooth stone. He wants 10 stacks of dark or spruce wood. We're probably going to have to go to my log farm to grab that. He's not sure how dark he wants to make one of the buildings. I almost think spruce would be best, but we'll check out what supplies we have. He wants 5 stacks of oak log, which we have a little bit of oak log. We're going to actually put this in the tree store, whatever extra stuff we have. He wants 1 stack of red wool, which I'm going to check what wool we have down here. He wants 1 stack of yellow wool, 1 stack of purple wool. If you haven't seen this, go check out my channel. So we got a bunch of green. What are you doing? We got one guy right in a minecart. I put him in there. This is awesome. You go, dude. You have your fun. Alright, so we do not have any. We have almost a stack of yellow. 1 stack of white wool, we don't even have that, and then 1 stack of vines, which we'll probably have to go get some of those. And he also asked for 1 obsidian chest, enough obsidian to make a portal, and a stack of coal. Sorry, chicken, I gotta take your spot. Doom. Alright, so we got the stone. That's good. You don't need the egg. Gotta get the coal real quick. Got a stack of coal blocks. He didn't say coal blocks, but I'll give him coal blocks. Because I'm just that kind of a nice guy. White wool, vines. So, 5 stacks of oak logs. That's not terrible. So he has built this in the desert because he wants to kind of have that biblical theme of a desert. He's already started construction on a couple of things. Again, check out my channel if you want to know what that's about. And so he's clearing all the cactus out there, kind of prepping, terraforming the whole process, enjoying that. All right. So we'll jump on here. While we ride there, I want to talk a little bit about fear. And we do have to stop at the shop real quick to pick up the rest of the stuff. Probably shear, a couple of vines as we go along. That being said, probably wouldn't be too hard to just give him the vines if we don't get enough. Alright, so grab those shears. He said a stack of vines. So I figure I'd just use, that was dumb. There we go. I really need to just make a vine farm. I don't have one. There we go. Cool. All right, so we got this. Those are birch, acacia, dark oak, and spruce, and jungle. So the dark oak, I kind of like the spruce. I almost want to just give him this. So one gold block per stack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 he asked for. And then the oak we'll give him here in just a second. And the wool. The other place you can get finds are the church. So I'll snag some of these here in just a sec. Let me empty my inventory. I do have one ender chest in here that I'll be taking as well. Alright, so we got those. Put that in there and that in there. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Beautiful. My horse keeps wandering off. Come on, bud. Alright, so let's stick the rest of this oak in the wood shop over here. And we should be good to go. Beautiful. Get the rest of the vines. So, if you're curious, I am doing a lot more videos on my personal channel, like I said. But you'll notice that we haven't been on here for quite a while as far as videos. I have not done anything in quite a bit of time. There's a reason for that. And the reason may not necessarily be the best reason, but the last episode that we did on here afterwards, I was standing by, I think I was actually by the farm, the water farm out there, the water temple farm, because I think I drowned again, and I was wearing all of my armor, and I was super frustrated, and I keep getting this mentality of I would like to AFK by the place, but then it wasn't like I was gone for more than a couple of minutes. I think it was probably 20 minutes because I had to go help my wife, and I was just staying there. I'm like, okay, that's fine. I'll just stand here. I didn't think it would take too long, and when I came back, I was dead. I lost all my armor because it despawned by that point, and I was super frustrated. And so, in some sense, I was burnt out, but in another sense, I was just worried, if I keep playing this game, am I just going to be wasting a lot of time? And so there was this fear, which is the topic for this, of I'm just afraid that I am wasting my time with this. I really like this game. It's not like I'm not getting a lot out of it. And this Minecraft Theology, the reason I'm doing this Minecraft Theology, I'm not going to be doing Let's Plays for ChurchMag. I personally, it doesn't mean that the team won't be doing it. But I don't want to do Let's Plays for this channel anymore just because it takes a lot of work to do this and to get it going. I think I got too many vines. So there's this fear that was going on with this. And this is a very small fear. It's a video game. But this concern of fear and what it does to our lives and how can we continue to maintain excellence in our faith, in our professional life, in our family, and all these different things that are going on, how can we continue to hold well to those is a tough question. I actually want to put some vines there just to have them. There we go. And one of the things that I love about doing Minecraft Theology is we get to talk about the theology of this stuff. So the theology of fear with, we only have, oh my goodness. Well, all right. We need to get some more purple wool. He said 1 stack of white, 1 stack of purple, which will make, won't be, oh, is it the other way? Is it like that? Okay, there we go. So purple, and then just, oh, that I used up all the purple. Okay, that's shocking. And there was enough purple there, dang it. Okay, and then yellow, I need 1 stack of red, 1 stack of yellow. Stack of red, 1 stack of yellow. I can put the rest in here. Cool. And am I forgetting anything? So 3 stacks of smelted stone, red, 10 stacks of dark oak or dark logs, we got that, or the spruce, I guess we got, 5 stacks of oak logs, we got this, 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 this. The vines we got. The ender chest I gotta go pick up. The obsidian. Oh, I need to get the obsidian. The obsidian, sir. I don't think I have any in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I owe this 2 diamonds. That's not a problem. So put that in there. Put those in there. Excellent. So, fear. How do you handle fear? And I think that it's important to realize that fear comes in all shapes and sizes. There is the fear that happened with this election. There's the fear of this president coming into candidacy. Where in the world did my horse go? There's the fear that I've lost my horse. There's the fear of what's going to happen with college. Am I going to pay my bills? What am I going to do the rest of my life? Am I even going to be able to graduate high school? Am I going to be able to make friends? Are my parents going to get back together? Is God going to love me even if I screwed up and didn't screw up that big but still screwed up again for the 100 millionth time? Or this time I really screwed up and I don't even think I can forgive myself, let alone God forgive me. And so there's all this different kinds of fear that can happen in your faith. And there's a couple of Bible verses I want to read to you real quick that I think is important when we talk about faith. First one comes from 1 Peter 5, chapter 5, verse 7. I'm going to get lost as I'm trying to recite this, aren't I? There we go. All right. Here's my, you'll notice that from some of the stuff I've been building and recording videos with. So the video, or the 1 Peter 5, 7 goes like this. Casting all of your care upon him, for he cares for you. So this mentality that we have a whole bunch of different cares, concerns, worries, and things that we feel like we need to hold on to. 1 Peter talks about this mentality that we need to just go ahead and cast them to God in our prayers. And it's not necessarily taking this away. It's when they talk about casting, it's not make everything easy for me. But it is this acknowledgement that this God that we have our trust and faith in, that we acknowledge as being all-powerful, we should probably allow ourselves to trust in him in this process. Does not mean that things are going to become super easy. But then you take this verse and you pair it with Philippians 4, 6 and 7, which gets quoted a ton when we talk about worry and stress. It says, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and application with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." And for me, that is a verse that says, let all of your worries be cast on him. Now, it doesn't mean forget about it. You're not going to just stop addressing the issue. But that crippling fear, that mentality that things are just not going to ever happen, you need to let it go and to give it to God in this process. Again, we are not going to forget it. It's still going to be one of the hardest things that we ever do, whatever it is. We are still going to be putting a ton of effort, a ton of time, and a ton of, how am I going to get over there? A ton of, sorry, I'm kind of stupefied by this. Oh, and I'm dismounted. Well, hello, squid. You're right. Go on. But we should not give up hope. And I think that's a huge thing. There's different levels of worrying. There's the Jesus literally was so concerned and stressed by the sins that he bore when he was on the cross that he bled, which is actually a medical issue that people can have, that they're so stressed out that they actually bleed from their veins because their capillaries have actually broken down. Kind of gross, I know, I'm sorry. But it's actually something that has been proven by science. It's not like it's just a figment of your imagination. Again, I kind of gave you a little spoiler over there. Go check out the video if you want to see what that's about. But then there's also the Colossians, and all of these are from the New Testament. This is the hope that we can have in Christ that we should hold on to as we continue to live in faith with God. So Colossians says, "Let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you are called in one body, and be thankful." So we have these worries. We have these day-to-day worries. We have these seasons that we are in. And if you have read any kind of book on how to continue to do well in life, you know about the verse that talks about for everything there is a season. And so sometimes those seasons are very difficult, and sometimes those seasons are very pleasant. And there will be a season for everything that we do. And that's okay as we have these seasons. All right. Somewhere around here is a bridge that I need to jump on. Let me check my map because we are going quite a distance. Let's see. Oh, my. Don't hurt my horse, you meanie. All right. So we are about halfway there. Let's see. Am I going the right way? Yes. The other part of this conversation is that in the worry and the fear that we have, people try to state that fear in and of itself is a bad thing. And the Bible actually says a lot of positive things about fear, specifically towards God. The fact that we are actually supposed to fear God. They talk about how fear tactics are terrible, which is true, but you should not rule in the sense of having people cower against you. But I would not say that the fear that we have for God is a cowarding, but a bowing down and an acknowledgement of Him. So let me quickly switch my Bible over, find a quick safe spot outside of all these trees, maybe. There we go. I'm scared about the mobs, which is an applicable part of this conversation. Stay away from me, zombie. All right, so let me flip real quick. So the other part of the understanding of fear, Proverbs 14 says, "In the fear of the Lord there is strong confidence, and his children will have a place of refuge. The fear of the Lord is a foundation of life, to turn away from the snares of death." And then later it says in Proverbs, or in earlier it says in Proverbs 9:10, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding." And so we have this mentality that fear is something we should completely avoid, except it is the essential crux of how we should approach God in fear, but also in reverence. And so just being able to say that you fear the Lord, because in essence, He holds all the keys. And if you decide to mock Him and to hold sin above what His law has said, then you should be very scared, because there are consequences to those actions. And so being able to hold strong to your faith as you move forward. And so there's this fear that we should have with that as well. Where am I going? I think I'm going the right way. All right, let me jump back onto the right path back here, and we will be there soon. And I did grab this good. I will be right back. All right, I have reoriented myself. I kind of did circles back there. I'm still gonna have to go back. That's okay. But we are over here. I need to remember to give 2 diamonds, because I will forget before I get back. All right, let's come this way. I think we just saw a couple of the structures for this. Yes, so he found a little town out here. Looks like he's got a lot of different things going on. That's cool. I like. Nice. I wonder what this is supposed to be. I think everything is going to be symbolic. So kind of interested just to see whenever he puts all the stuff over here. Oh, I've trapped myself. There we go. I wonder if that's like the lion's den, or maybe that's the mate. That's the manger, I bet, for Jesus. All right. And then if we hop this, we got some. I know he was doing olive trees, which is why he's getting rid of all the cactus, because there's no cactus in Jerusalem. I love it. I love it. I love it. Sir, you've done good work. Oh, I'm going to hurt myself. I just want to see what's in the chest because I'm nosy. He's going to build the ark. You know, no big thing, just the ark. How do you get in here? Is there a door? Oh, there we go. Snooping, snooping, snooping. Steal some of your chests. All right, so let's go ahead and come out here. We'll put this. I'm going to use this, then we'll break it and put it back. So put all this stuff in here. Beautiful. Excellent. Wonderful. Dun, 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 dun. Well, that just doesn't make sense. Let's do that. So there is almost everything he's asked for. Done and done. I feel like we should put up a sign just saying, hey, we have delivered your stuff. He is going to give us a fee, but I also would like him. We have that iron farm over at our at Spawn Town. I would really like for him, if he would be willing to do so, to make us auto destruction for the seeds, the poppy or the poppy flowers that we get, because they're just annoying. We don't need them. All right, so there's that. Stick this back in here. I stole those. Sorry. Here are your supplies as requested. I'm willing to call it a trade if you are willing to put in that. Well, now I just need to. All right. What am I doing? If you are willing to. All right, let's try this again. Sorry, guys. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun. Beautiful. Did I lose a sign somehow? I think I. Oh, no, there it is. Here are the supplies that you requested. If you are okay with it, let's call it an even trade. If you will go make that poppy flower destruct-o-matic at the Spawn Town iron farm for me, please. Gateway station. Awesome, guys, we did it. Yay! So, I'd like to hear what you guys have to say about the topic of fear. What is your own personal experiences with fear? I know I've had a lot in my past. I was worried about, I have an exam coming up in less than a week that if I don't pass, I just spent $250 on, and also says something about my incompetence and worthiness and Should I even be doing this kind of a job? And it doesn't really say those things, but those are some of the things that go through my head as I'm kind of doing this. There's also a child that's, by the time this comes out, oh, am I feeding him? Okay. As soon as this comes out, the child will already be here. But I've never raised a daughter, and I don't know how that's going. And just this pregnancy hasn't been bad, but we're getting closer and closer, and all of our children have come early so far. I don't want our child to have to stay in the NICU, and that's a possibility as far as this hospital is concerned. So there's some fear about that. So there's fear that's external, where we don't have that much control over it. And yet we still have to acknowledge what we can do with it, acknowledging also that there's a lot that's outside of our own control, and there's also God's will in this whole process too. And then there's fear that we can own a lot of the whole situation, and we just kind of need to keep pressing in and keep doing what we need to do to be successful. So I'd love to hear what you guys have to say about this. I'm going to run back to Spawn Town, get things in order for the next video, but I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye. See ya. This is not good because I know there's huge holes. Oh well. See you guys. Bye. There was one I almost ran into. See ya. Bye.